Ticker tape, fanfare, a true hero's homecoming.
I'm just proud to be Australian.
This was Brisbane's first official Olympic homecoming parade after the Los Angeles Games in 1984. Medalists in a fleet of vintage cars were cheered from the sidewalk. Office workers climbed onto shop awnings for a better view.
Thank you to all of you that turned out this morning. It was just tremendous. I didn't think that Brisbane had this many people.
After Seoul in 1988, the crowds along Queen Street were even bigger. Rocky boy Duncan Armstrong had won gold and silver in Korea, and coach Laurie Lawrence wanted everyone to know.
Here's the animal. We take the handcuffs off. Here's the animal.
But this story's bias hits bronze medalist Julie McDonald. After all,
even reporters have sisters. Darren McDonald, 7 years.
My brother.
20 years ago, after the Athens Games, the likes of Grant Hackett and Jodie Henry were treated like rock stars.
It's the biggest thing that's ever happened to me in my life. I just couldn't believe it. And he hugged me. He hugged me. And did he kiss me too? Oh, my God!
We can't thank them enough. I mean, without them, we wouldn't get as far as we got.
Be invited to the Lions game tonight and have to dress up nice and have a nice dinner and everything. And it's like, why would they invite me to that? But it's exciting.
After Beijing, Golden Girl Stephanie Rice was the star of the parade, and like each of the homecomings, the athletes were awarded the keys to the city.
This is amazing. It's such a great turnout, and I really wanted to be here for Brisbane.
So after Queensland's great success in Paris, what's in store when our athletes get home? Brisbane City Council is working with the state government, the AOC and Paralympics Committee on a plan. The details will be confirmed soon. One thing's for sure, it'll go off with a bang. Advance Australia.